subscribe to Bizbo and press the bell icon. See boring news turn into enjoyable stories. It was a normal working day at Kitex, the world's second largest children's apparel park, when suddenly, a group of uniformed police officers stormed the gates.
There are complaints about mistreatment of workers and pollution of the river. We need to do an inspection. Now.
This was the 11th inspection in a month. Understandably, Sabu M. Jacob, the company's managing director, was livid. He lashed out in the press.
The government is trying to push us into a corner by harassing us constantly.
Then delivered a killer blow to Kerala's economy.
We will no longer be going ahead with our 3,500 crore investment in Kerala.
Within days of the announcement, Telangana's Industry Minister K.T. Rama Rao sent a private jet to fly Jacob to Hyderabad, enticing him with benefits to invest in his state. Just before departing, Jacob fired another salvo at Chief Minister Pinarayi Vijayan.
The world has changed a lot, but Kerala refuses to change. We are 50 years behind other states.
Within days taking up the Hyderabadi's offer and announcing a 2,406 crore investment in two major industrial parks in Telangana. Almost immediately, the battered Kitex stock rose by a whopping 86%. After initially being defensive, the chief minister admitted,
"Our government has an open approach towards issues raised by the Kitex group."
As they should, because apart from garments, Kitex also manufactures aluminium products, curry powders, school bags, etc. And by providing 10,000 jobs, it is also Kerala's largest private sector employer. Which raises the question, what prompted such hostility between Jacob and Vijayan in the first place? As is mostly the case nowadays, it seems political compulsions have something to do with it. After facing local ire for polluting water bodies in Kizhakkambalam, the site of Kitex's aluminium factory, Jacob in 2015 floated a voluntary organization called 2020, backed by Kitex's huge kitty of corporate social responsibility, CSR funds. Initially, it was aimed at making the panchayat of Kizhakkambalam, roughly 25 kilometers from Kochi city, the best village in the country by 2020, hence the name. He took a bunch of dingy and dilapidated old houses in the Laksham Vidhu colony and turned it into God's villa.
Sounds almost like Godzilla, but no, it was probably a little dig at Kerala's long-standing advertising campaign, God's Own Country. Kitex's Kizhakkambalam country consisted of paved roads and a supermarket from which residents could buy things at 50% less than what it was priced outside. Not surprisingly, 2020 won 18 of the 19 wards and 2 of the 3 block panchayat seats when Kitex decided to contest local elections, making it the first time a corporate firm got control over a panchayat body in India. Not only did it retain power in Kizhakkambalam in 2020, it also captured 3 other neighbouring panchayats, relegating established political parties LDF, UDF, Congress, CPM and the BJP to also rans. But Sabu sir, as Joseph is respectfully called, crossed a political red line when Kitex challenged Pinayari in the state's 2020 assembly elections by fielding candidates in 8 constituencies in Ernakulam district. And even though they lost in all of them, it still managed to dent the prospects of LDF and UDF candidates in Kunnathunad. Jacob's move to enter politics first through local bodies and then the assembly seems to have rubbed political parties the wrong way. However, while political harassment may well have been the ultimate reason for Kitex's departure from Kerala, there is also a financial one. The increasing costs of labour and land is another reason for my decision not to invest further in Kerala. Kerala may be paying a price for its high literacy rate. 72.5% of women have completed 10 or more years of schooling, compared to just 35.7% for India as a whole. But the labor-intensive garment industry does not require educated workers, who obviously will demand a higher wage, the very cost garment manufacturers want to reduce, so as to compete with countries like Bangladesh, which pay just 100 rupees a day as compared to 315 in Kerala. Kitex has so far countered this issue by not employing locals and hiring the bulk, 80% of its workforce from outside Kerala.
Assam, Odisha, Jharkhand, Nagaland.
So by now setting up in Telangana, Kitex will be closer to the lower wage markets of Odisha, Chhattisgarh and Jharkhand, where the daily wage is about 200 rupees a day, as well as operate bang in the middle of India's largest cotton growing region, perfect for a cloth manufacturer. Further, Kerala already has a bad rap when it comes to ease of doing business, ranking at 28 out of 36 states and union territories. Companies like MRF have declared multiple lockouts at its Vadavathur Kottayam factory. So was the preemptive neutralization of Kitex's political threat worth the price the people of Kizhakambalam would pay from his exit? Being popular and winning a few local panchayat seats did not translate into victory in the much larger state polls. Plus, instances of Kitex's alleged autocratic behavior was also hurting them, like cancellation of supermarket memberships for people who supported other political outfits, non-repairing of roads or houses of political opponents. It was even alleged that auto drivers simply entering their supermarket premises were forced to affix their brand stickers on vehicles. India has seen quite a few company towns, the most famous among them of course being Jamshedpur, set up by Tata Steel in 1919, which now has a current population of over 600,000. Others include two set up by Grasim Industries of Aditya Birla Group, Kumarapatnam, Karnataka and Nagda, Madhya Pradesh, Larsen & Toubro's town Kansbahal, Orissa and Bhels at Kailasapuram, Tirunachapalli. Each built residential colonies, schools and hospitals, some even built a stadium and open-air theatres. But none ventured into politics, which in hindsight was probably a good thing. Philanthropists the world over, and even our very own Azim Premji, who has given away over 100,000 crore, almost $15 billion, also shuns the political arena. Of course, the most notorious company town or commune really was Rajneeshpuram in Oregon, USA, that collapsed after the death of its guru amid murder plots, poisoning, political intimidation and intrigue. Other world-famous company towns include Hershey, Pennsylvania, built in 1900 and still making chocolates today. Steinway Village in Queens, New York, built in 1853 and now merged with the Big Apple, still makes more than 1,000 of the most exquisite pianos each year. It will certainly be a historic feat if Kitex in Kizhakambalam is still producing garments 100 years from now. But perhaps Kerala's future lies away from labor-intensive manufacturing. Kerala's advantage is not in sweatshops, but in new-age knowledge-based industries. Fittingly, its IT parks Info Park in Kochi and Techno Park in Thiruvananthapuram are now nearly fully occupied. In March, the American-listed but Indian-owned firm Cognizant picked Kerala's commercial capital Kochi as the only Indian city to be part of its coveted 21 places of the future list. After factoring physical infrastructure, environment, lifestyle, culture and entertainment, talent pools and affordability, among others. With over 60,000 engineers graduating from Kerala each year, it could certainly be one of the big players in India's IT sector. Meanwhile, the Kitex vs. Kerala row has only inflamed, with two more inspections being carried out recently, none of which yielded anything, according to an RTI report obtained from the agricultural officer, Kizhakambalam. In Kitex's episode, may lie lessons for Sterlite, who too could use a similar model to build confidence among the locals in Thoothukudi. And while it may be true that Kerala needs to move to more wage-appropriate businesses, doing so over the grave of manufacturing can only damage its reputation and future prospects. Bizbo's limerick. A hassled Kitex left Kerala in a huff when its corporate initiatives were soundly rebuffed. A red line they crossed, a kingdom they lost. For the people of Kizhakambalam, that's going to be tough. Subscribe to Bizbo and click on the bell icon to get notified whenever Bizbo releases a new video. Sources of all our information is listed in the video description section.